Hello, everybody. Welcome to Capacity TV. I think this is the first of the interviews that we're running in here over the next couple of days. My name's Jack Haddon, and I'm a reporter with Capacity Media. We're here. I'm very delighted to be joined by Michaël Trabbia, who's CEO at Orange Wholesale. Michaël, thank you very much for joining me.
Thank you, Jack.
And I believe, like me, this is your first Capacity Europe, first time here as CEO of the wholesale division at Orange. It's a role you took in April 2023, so about 6 months in. And you're launching the activities under the new brand of Orange Wholesale. Can you tell us more about that and what's driving the change behind the whole rebrand at Orange?
Yes, thank you, Jack. And it's super exciting to be here at Capacity Europe. As you said, it's my first time, but we can feel the industry really in this old building with everybody gathering around. And then you said that we just launched a new brand, Orange Wholesale, which is basically around joining forces. We are a very big player. The wholesale business at Orange is 7.4 billion euros, so it's a very big business. We are number one in EMEA in many areas. And for us, this is about bringing solution, because what we see, and we can all feel that, is that internet is as vital as the air we breathe. And basically, what we bring is answers to challenges that are linked to that criticality of the internet. We need more and more internet, more traffic. We need more resilience and security. And we need also digitalization of our services and access to our network and infrastructure.
Mm-hmm. Brilliant. And so there's a new plan that was unveiled by your CEO, Crystal Heidemann, that was called Lead for the Future. So why don't you tell us a little bit more about what that is and how it specifically applies to what you plan at Orange Wholesale?
Yeah. Yes, our new CEO, Christelle Edemann, launched the Lead the Future plan, which is basically around focusing on our core business. And I do believe as telco, we have a lot to do to serve our customers. And to do that, we really want to bring the best infrastructure and the best networks to our customers. So that's basically the Lead the Future plan. And to be able to do that, to invest, to continue investing in our infrastructure, in our networks, we need to monetize those assets. And so that's why we have decided to create this Orange Wholesale branch in order to monetize both on the retail side, but also on the wholesale side, our infrastructure. And this allows us to roll out a lot of fiber. We have 50 million home passed in fiber, for instance, to lay submarine cables. We have 450,000 kilometers of submarine cables to roll out the terrestrial fiber. So that's really important for us in order to have the best infrastructure, the best network, to share them, to mutualize them. And that's really a core element of the industry. This is good for the financial. This is good for the carbon footprint of the industry.
Mm-hmm. And I guess ultimately, what does all of that mean for your customers? And it'd be good, I think, if you could expand a little bit on how this kind of like new centralized structure helps and plays into some of these ambitions.
Yeah, so as I mentioned, when we want to invest more in infrastructure, the logic for us is to move towards from a retail-centric logic, where we invested basically for our retail need, for our own customer need, and we commercializing more or less what is left to the wholesale market. And we are moving to a more industry-centric approach, where we invest, taking into account the needs of all the industry. And that's really a shift in paradigm that allows us to invest in more capacity, in more terrestrial fiber. For instance, we are looking in some very concrete projects for long haul that we would not have looked at before. Second topic is software transformation. And we are really moving forward, and we are at the forefront of software transformation, first on our network. And we are softwarizing our point of presence all around the world. We have 1,000 point of presence all around the world, and we are putting services, API on those services to our customers. And last but not least, what's really important for us is trust. I mean, trust is key in our industry. And this comes with sustainability, environment, which is very important for us, but also neutrality, because we are both a retail player and a wholesale player. And creating Orange Wholesale is also the guarantee that we are open, we have open infrastructure, and we are neutral to all our customers. We serve them with the same excellent spirit that we have for our internal needs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. And you know, we've seen a lot, I think, from businesses all over the world, really. And I know it's a big theme of what's being discussed over the 3 days on this stage and at the stage downstairs, is like the as a service model.
Yeah.
So how does that kind of like fit into Orange Wholesale's ethos? And yeah, what kind of like changes have you made to your portfolio to be able to enable that?
So we have started to really invest in our network to bring those capabilities. So we have telco cloud available. We have our router that are disaggregated. And this is live today on our international network. And then what's more important is to have offers to our customers that you can consume as a service. And that's what we have done. For instance, we have an offer which is called EVPL, Ethernet Virtual Private Line, that you can literally order and provision in one click. And whatever the number of networks it takes to go through, you can provision one access, one connectivity from your location to whatever hyperscaler zone, for instance. We have a UCP, universal CP offer that allow to provision services, can be security services, for instance, firewall, flow prioritization to the customer premise. We download, we upload to the CPE the right software to manage that service. Mm-hmm. So that's really concrete for us. Obviously, this is the beginning of the story. And our vision is that everybody will be interconnected via API. So we propose APIs to other players. We are able also to use partner APIs in order to bring this connectivity as a service at the end of the day for our customers. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned this is the beginning of the story. Maybe let's like flip forward a few chapters. If we can look at some of the investments that Orange Wholesale are planning, what are some of the areas that you think are going to be like core for you guys to look at and really like, you know, invest in over the next coming years?
So this is a key question, because obviously investments are limited and there's so much to do on infrastructure and network. So first, on domestic network, this is very important for us. This is about fiber. We plan to roll out 9 million additional fiber home passed by 2025. So that's really coming soon. We plan also to have new towers. We have a significant tower co, which is Totem. It's the fifth one at European level. And we are going to invest and to roll out new towers. And then this is about continuing investing in submarine cables. We are one of the very big players in the submarine cables all around the world, not only in the big routes, such as transatlantic, trans-Pacific routes, also along Africa, but also to connect the remote areas. And this is very important for us. And on terrestrial fiber, this is also to interconnect data centers, because what we see is that data centers are more and more, we have more and more data centers everywhere, not only in the FLAP. We see data centers and hyperscalers willing to invest in data centers. You need to connect those data centers. You need to bring diversity and resilience to those data centers, meaning that you need to have at least three routes connecting each data centers. And that's why we want to leverage on our assets. And we are very strong in Europe. Thanks to our domestic presence, we are going to leverage our domestic presence, our ducts, for instance, to build routes and extra capacity and diversity for the data center interconnections.
Amazing. Well, Michaël, thank you so much for joining me. Really great chatting with you. Thanks everyone for coming and checking this out as well. There'll be a load more interviews like this coming up over the next 3 days. And for everyone that's watching this online, thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe, like, ring the bell so you can get more of these interviews straight to your PC or your tablet, wherever you're watching. Yeah, thanks very much for joining us, guys. And thanks again to Michaël.
Thank you, Jack.
Thank you.
Thank you.